We have a large dominant cyst, and I'm keeping my transducer a little bit right of the midline of the liver. So that would be in the right lobe of the liver, we have this dominant cyst. We can try to take a measure on it, just to have an idea what size we are speaking about. And we are speaking about the size of 11-12 centimeter. We can see there is plenty of normal liver tissue in between, but there is some quite large dominant cyst and a number of smaller cysts as well. On the left lobe here, again keeping it so we're having the aorta in the lower part of the image, I can here try to add the color. And we can identify the aorta here in front of the spinal structure. Then we will move away from here, that is in the left liver lobe, we go to the right liver lobe and all the way upwards as far as the dissection allows. And then we can see the cystic structures out here become more complex, whereas it is a little more simple cystic appearance here. You can see the cyst I have in the anterior part of the image now. Let us put an arrow on. Here we have the surface of the liver, and here we have very thin layer into a cyst. And from that cyst there's only a very small septa and another small septa to the borderline of the dominant cyst. So if we could break down this area here, then we will be directly taking the three largest cysts in the left liver lobe and the large in the right. That will definitely give us a good access. On the other hand, to the anterior, more lateral and anterior part of the liver, then you will have a certain amount of liver tissue, and that will not be a good window for it. And then there might be another window in the back of the of the right side, laterally on the liver. I think we should do the contrast to evaluate whether the remaining liver tissue is as normal as it appears. So I think we will prepare the contrast. We inject the contrast, and in the same moment we start the injection, then we will also start a stop clock, which will start counting up. That will provide us an idea about which phase we are looking at, and also used for documentation afterwards. We will have the contrast image to the on the left side on the screen, corresponding to the guiding image in black and white ultrasound on the right side of the screen. Now we can see the contrast is appearing. The cyst will of course remain dark and without any flow, and now we can see the vascular structures. And that is why I also want to evaluate the structures of the septas. For instance, between here, we have to face that there is actually a vascular structure between these two. On the other hand, between these two, there's not a vascular structure. So it can provide us quite important information. Here we have the cyst as we planned actually to make the de-roofing at. And here we can see that there's no vascular structures inside this area. There is maybe one here, which we also can see corresponding here. But this area here, we can make the roofing. And at here, that will also be without any larger vessels. So I think actually it is a good way to demonstrate that we can do this in a safe way to fulfill our aim, de-roofing and finding a way through three other cystic volumes until we reach the large dominant cyst in the right liver lobe. Let us go around and see on the smaller cysts and if they should hide any solid structures in between in the liver. And there's a considerable amount of wealthy, normal looking tissue or liver parenchyma, which is good for the patient's prognosis. directly from the central sterilization department, we receive the small box here. That is containing the devices which we need for this steering. As we can see, there is three channels which we are going to select between, for which angle we perform the puncture under. So this is the devices which we need. And then we will have to assemble it. By placing this locker system here, which has a small tap which is containing the movable part here in a position where we can utilize it. So I just open it, place it and close it again. Now the whole system is that we have three access points here in a fixed angulation, which we again can fix to our transducer by this bracket. So placing the bracket in position and then placing the whole unit, and there we can see the advantage that the communication to the transducer has been done here, which is a very unique design, allowing us actually to make the puncture in this direction. Then we need the puncture needle. We're going to perform the puncture with an 18 gauge normal spinal needle, and we can just see that we should be able to pass through here, otherwise we will have to find another insertion for that needle diameter. Each needle diameter has its own bracket, and here we have a large bore needle dimension here. So by placing this one here, then we should be able to place the needle and keep it into the steering device. The 18 gauge needle insertion device here, I control and make a check that we actually can pass with the needle. Then we are approaching and we are finding the best route for the puncture. And that I will do without Doppler first, and then I will add the Doppler as a kind of check-up before I do the insertion. I can actually see already that we have vascular structures here. But since we have the steering device, then we can do it quite precisely, and we don't need to be anxious to pass through here a vascular structure. So the middle of the three needle routes would be the one I prefer. I take off the Doppler and I keep the same access point here. And then I will perform the puncture. And we can see the needle is now into the first cyst, and then it's into the second cyst, and then we are penetrating here down there to the third cyst. Then we can take out the stylet. And then the cystic fluid is being emptied. We are emptying the cystic cavity with a normal syringe.